Gentlemen, forgive me for disturbing you again, but I have a little problem.
A little problem, a little problem. Everyone has little problems now, you know.
They are kept to oneself, and they don't stop the world from turning.
Nor trains from leaving stations.
Some sailors have agreed to tow the train, but I don't have enough money to pay them. I was wondering if you could help me out. For a while. I could work for the money.
Please wait, miss. We have certain confibulations to attend to.
That is right. We must confibulate between ourselves. A collegiate decision must be taken.
I hope that we are not indisposing you in any way.
Why not?
If it helps us get rid of that train.
My word, that is a fine idea.
What do you have in mind, gentlemen?
When you arrived here, you must have noticed a splendid bandstand which honors the main university courtyard.
A unique piece of mechanical craftsmanship which no longer works, alas.
Why, yes, we have very moving memories of its melodies. We're prepared to offer you a financial reward if you can set it working again.
With pleasure. What do I have to do?
Unfortunately, my dear, time and rust have taken their toll on this university, and our automatons no longer have a spring in their step. You are going to have to be resourceful.
To tell you the truth, there are a number of complex mechanisms here in Barrockstadt, and it would appear that we have unfortunately lost their operating instructions.
Your train, however, is an extremely ingenious invention, so you should be no stranger to complex mechanisms, should you? We are therefore counting on your ingenuity, miss.
I hope that I can show myself worthy of your faith in me, gentlemen.
Well, my dear colleagues, one more university matter nicely tied up.
Here we are, busy chatting, and look at the clock. It's tea time.
Already? My word, doesn't time fly by?
Thank you for a charming visit, miss.
And thank you, gentlemen.